Hey guys, I am directing Pete and welcome to another great video. In this video, we are gonna go through how to use an objective device as a prop. And we're gonna use those props around your creative map and create amazing stuff. We'll have interaction where you can hide gold under the bed or weapons that get revealed when you break an objective device. We're also going to be using objective devices to blow stuff up because we love to do that in our maps. So we're gonna go ahead and use an objective device to go ahead and create some explosions, some little ones, and a massive one as well. So we have a lot to cover in this video, but before we get started, go ahead and hit that like button if you could. It just helps me out so much. And if you didn't like the video by the end, you can go ahead and unlike it later. Go ahead and subscribe too if you think I'm doing a good job. Also, if you want to see these objective devices in action, you can go to my map, Directing Pete's Battle Royale. The code is there in the video and also in the description below. Go ahead and check that out. All right, let's get started. So the first thing we're going to go ahead and do is grab an objective device from the objective devices gallery, which is right here. Here's a really cool thing, guys. If you use one objective device, it doesn't cost more memory to use a different style of that objective device. Now it does, but only 20 more, which is pretty cool because normally when you use different props, it can cost you 500 or 600 memory each for different props. But with objective devices, if you use one style, you can use any of the styles for only 20 memory more. That's why I filled them up all over my map. So guys, you got to see all the objective devices. I'm gonna go ahead and choose the bed. So I have a blank canvas here. I already saved the bed as what I wanted, and I used some settings that I saved from before. So I'm gonna place this bed down using Grid Snap 32 because it usually gets it to be more even than not for placement. Perfect. Now, when we go ahead and edit these settings, you'll see here that I chose a max health of 5,000. You can go lower or higher, but I want people to work for this a little bit because I'm giving away a pretty good reward. No blast radius because we're not gonna blow up the bed. We're just gonna reveal a reward. So we're gonna leave all these settings alone. Hide health bar at always. For me, I wanna hide the health bar. If you show the health bar, it shows people on the map where the hidden prop is that gives you the secret thing. You don't wanna give that away. You want people to discover it on their own. So I turn that as always. Everything else you can leave on its default setting. And then at the end, when destroyed, transmit on, choose an empty channel. I have empty channel 51. That's my next available channel. So I chose that. You're gonna choose a channel that is blank on your map. Once you've chosen that, you're gonna go ahead and hit okay, and we're gonna move on to the next device. All right, and under devices, we're gonna go ahead and choose our next device, which is going to be our item spawner. We grabbed our item spawner and we're gonna place them. You can place it directly under the bed if you'd like, but I'm gonna place one on each side of the bed because I'm actually giving away two items when you break the bed. Actually, I'm gonna end up deleting one and then copying it over. It will just make it easier to do the settings once. So in here, I'm gonna do item respawns on, random spawns I'm gonna leave off. However, if you want it to choose different spawns each time, maybe you put more than one item in there and it spawns a different item randomly, well, you're gonna wanna go from off to random. That way it will choose a different item every time. For this though, I wanna keep it pretty normal. You just know what you get when you select or break that bed. Visible during games, off. Now guys, I do want this off because all that applies to is the base at the bottom. I don't wanna see the base at the bottom of the bed. I want it to be invisible. So I'm gonna leave visible during games off. Time before first spawn. Now for this, I'm gonna change it to never. It won't work correctly if you do have it set to anything else because then it will just spawn automatically. We wanna set it to never because it's gonna be a channel that decides this, not the timer. Same applies for time between spawns. I never wanna spawn this ever again. It's a one-time item for the person that finds it. So once again, I'm gonna set that to never. All right, we're gonna ignore all the rest of these settings and we're gonna just adjust one more setting. So bonus ammo for weapons on. Yes, I wanna leave that on because it just gives people the ammo they need for the weapon that you've chosen. Now run over pickup. If people have run over pickup turned off, this forces it on. I'm forcing it on for gold. Only for the gold, because I figure if you run over gold and it's in your inventory, it doesn't really matter. But I am gonna turn it off for the weapon because if somebody in their settings has run over pickup off, I don't wanna override that setting for them. Last but not least, we're gonna choose the same channel as the bed, which is channel 51. Now I'm gonna go ahead and copy this over and make a duplicate. And the only change I'm gonna make, because this is where the gun is gonna go, I'm gonna go ahead and change run over pickup off Once again, I don't want to override that setting for that person. All right, so let's go ahead and put our consumables in. There's the gold. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and drop about 60 gold. Now on my map, weapons cost about 5 to 10 gold, and you can normally only get gold by eliminating a player. This is a secret way to get gold without eliminations. This basically gives you free access to almost all the vending machines on the map. I wanted to up the game a little bit more though. We're also gonna give away a legendary minigun. So I'm gonna go ahead and drop a legendary minigun in. And now as you can see here, we have our minigun and our gold coins. Now let's go ahead and test our work. All right. And awesome, that worked beautifully. We were able to put two items. Run over on pickup is on for the gold. Now I have run over on pickup on already, so it automatically picked up the minigun. However, if somebody had that off, it would not allow auto pickup on that item. So next up, we have this awesome objective device here with a health of 10,000 memory. And you can see here, the gift is a Midas fish. Now, a Midas fish is pretty powerful, so I made the health double that of the bed. I wanna make this harder because if you have a full loadout of gray or green weapons, you can make them all legendary weapons with this. So we're gonna set it to 10,000 health. The other two options we're gonna change for this one is hide health bar at always. We never wanna show that health bar unless you wanna give away the location of where these props are, but that takes away the mystery of people finding it on your map and feeling like they found an Easter egg or something really cool. Last but not least, when destroyed, transmit on channel 52. Now, once again, we're gonna do the item spawner the exact same way that we did before. Visible during games off, time before first spawn never, time between spawns never, and then channel, we're gonna just crank that up to 52. So that's the only difference. Then we're gonna drop the Midas fish in, and that's it. Now, remember when we blew up that satellite dish? Now we did something a little different here. Health, I set much lower to 300, all right? Blast radius, which you see below there, I set to 1. So I actually did a new setting here. Now what's cool is, that's it. All you have to do when you place an objective device that explodes is set the health amount and the blast radius, hide health bar at, once again, we're gonna keep that at always. So you wanna keep hide health bar at always because once again, you don't want people to see where the health bar is. All right, and finally at Rainbow Rubik's, you're starting to get the point here. I hit another kind of like a bomb inside the water fountain and it's hidden, right? If I didn't show you, you may not know it's there. Set it to 10,000 again. This time I did a blast radius of 5. Hide health bar at always, just like before. And you don't have to do anything with channels. Now, because I made that blast radius so big, that would blow up the entire POI like you see here. Once again, I hope this tutorial helped you making your Fortnite creative maps even better. Please let me know in the comments below what other videos you'd like to see me create. Thank you so much for stopping by, and until next time, take care.